Now, once again, it's a conversation about leverage. It's that's the conversation we have about OPEC Plus and a number of other things. What leverage do the United States have at this point? Because there is no more maximum pressure.
I think there's two points to make here. So the first is that there was a readout from a senior State Department official talking with journalists across the weekend, and this is what it said. The U.S. said, Iran did not show the posture of a country that is seriously thinking of a rapid return to mutual compliance. So basically, the Iranian leadership team came back into the room, this new leadership team that they're now negotiating with, the seventh round of talks, and they walked back what had already been achieved and came back into the room asking for more. The reporting says apparently even China and Russia were surprised at how far the Iranians went.
Yeah, this is an administration or a regime, if you might call it that, which is, as we know, totally hardline. It comes off the back of the failure of the Rouhani presidency to get a deal done that would stick, everything that happened, you know, post Donald Trump's election. And at the end of the day, when you lift enough sanctions or barriers, you've got to wonder, you know, what skin in the game the Iranians really have at this point, because it seems as if they are more than willing to let it continue to go, you know, as bad as it could possibly get. I mean, remember COVID, how bad this was for this country. And yet at the same time, they didn't move whatsoever one iota on going back to a deal. And then the bigger question is, will they even begin to achieve a deal at this point that could potentially keep them from further enrichment of uranium? We know that they've already gone much further than was anticipated.
It's even been suggested that the Iranians would probably be looking towards a plan B now, so maybe even an abandonment of the JCPOA.
So the White House, you would think, would also be talking about a plan B as well.
That's
I guess
right.
They don't want to throw that ball out quite yet,
yeah.
I'd admit that. But that's what everyone is saying within the diplomatic community that we speak to.
But they're also saying that within the administration, there's probably a view forming now that the Iranians are looking to perhaps drag their feet on these talks, continue to build out their nuclear ambition and capability, and that only adds leverage
of
on
course.
Their side, you know, coming into whatever the next round of talks is going to be. No timeline on that, but really concerning here.
It's a song that we've sung before, so just keep waiting and watching. But certainly very telling that Sheikh Thaksin has made that visit to Iran today.
Correct.